Former American Idol contestant is stepping up to the mic, claiming he had an off-camera sort of something-something with Judge Paula Abdul. There is word he has taped phone calls to prove it. Wouldn't that be interesting? But Idol producers are asking fans not to cast their votes just yet. With us now is the Newsweek contributing editor, Mark Pizer. So what's going on American Idol? Is ABC simply trying to get some of the American Idol juice for the Alphabet Channel, or is there really a bunch of hanky-panky?
Well, I don't know about the hanky-panky. I think it's closer to both. I wasn't there, so I can't tell you about the hanky-panky. Clearly, ABC's trying to get some of the juice off of American Idol, which is a time-tested technique in network
television. We do it right. We're doing it right now.
But at least it's your own show.
Well, that's true.
This is another network. Well, but nonetheless, a relative. Yeah, I mean, clearly American Idol is a huge phenomenon. That doesn't mean that this isn't somewhat newsworthy. I mean, Paula Abdul was on the cover of People magazine last week. People would like to know if, in fact, she was taking some extracurricular activities along with some of her contestants, or at least one contestant.
Right. But you think the motives here are from the time-honored tradition of news magazines, which is just grab some ratings whenever you can.
Yeah, but I think it's legitimate news. American Idol is a huge phenomenon. Paula Abdul is a major celebrity, for better or for worse, in this country.
Sure.
And this is a questionable situation. I think that they have the right to pursue it.
Oh, absolutely. We do it every night. You know why? Because it gets ratings.
Well, there you are.
Can this show hang on?
Oh, yeah. I mean, this show eats scandal for breakfast. Every 3 months, there's another scandal, and it just comes back bigger and stronger. There is not a show on television, certainly of this caliber, that has had the number of problems that this has had, from voting problems with telephone lines to contestants with criminal backgrounds that we do and don't know of, including this guy who's accused Paula of being her boyfriend. It never ends, and people eat it up. This is not really a talent show anymore.
No.
It's basically a singing soap opera.
Yes.
And all this stuff just feeds people's passion for who's on and who's winning and who's up and who's down.
It's not a talent show anymore. It's now a singing soap opera. And see, I think that there, and correct me if I'm wrong, but I think there were a lot of people in families all across this country, in the middle of this country, sitting down with their families, watching this show. It's a family, good, wholesome, look at these nice kids, that sort of thing. And I wonder if some of the tarnish remains on it, if some of those families won't go, I ain't watching this soap opera.
You know, I think that too, but you know, one of these guys who's in the final five was accused of beating up his girlfriend, the mother of his child.
Yeah.
This kid was accused of beating up his teenage sister. That was why he was thrown off the show. You know, these are hardly squeaky clean kids through and through. I'm sure there are plenty of good ones in there. And every time I hear one of those revelations, I think, yeah, parents are not going to want their kids to see this, and more of them watch.
Huh? You know, I guess there is that tendency to look at car wrecks. You know, people say they don't want car chases on the air, and you put them up on the screen and they come by the millions. It's the same sort of thing, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, look, the family-friendly shows that are on television, the ones that are getting canceled, American Dreams on NBC, much praised for being a family-friendly show, people don't tune in to watch them. They like the salacious stuff. They like gossip.
Yeah, that's the truth. You know what I was stunned to find out? Now I know the root of all evil on this program.
Cheerleading.
Cheerleading. Mm. Paula Abdul was a cheerleader.
That's the beginning and the problems for her.
I think it is. I'm surprised they didn't just lock her up right then and there.
Look at the trouble she would have been saved.
Good grief almighty. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Kabuto's on deck. Stop.